Good evening. This is a regular scheduled Board of Education meeting. The board was in executive sessions. In accordance with Open Meeting Laws 105A, matters which will imperil the public safety if disclosed, discussions, security, safety, and cameras, and Open Meeting Laws 105F, specific personnel matters, retirees, health care insurance, MCAA, and Section 75 settlement agreement. If I could now please have Mr. Rothberg and his student to the podium to lead us in the pledge, and if you could all rise.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, and liberty of justice for all.
Well done. Great job, Stella. So good evening. It is my privilege to introduce Stella Portelli, who is the Elementary Student of the Month from Stagecoach Elementary School. On behalf of the Board of Education, I will be presenting Stella with this beautiful certificate. Excellent. Stella is an extremely hard worker at Stagecoach. Mrs. Dottori, Stella's fifth grade teacher, stated, "Stella always works her hardest to excel in everything that she does." Stella was the fifth grade contest winner for her Taking the Stand essay that she wrote and read as part of the first annual Humanities Festival. That was a great success. It took place last month. Stella wrote a very persuasive essay on why swimming should be part of gym class. Well, I told Stella we don't have a swimming pool here at Middle Country, but these are all the people that you could talk to about it. And you never know, maybe you go swimming one day. So I am so honored here to celebrate Stella for what she has meant to Stagecoach for the past 5 years. She is joined here tonight by her whole family right there. Well done. Very proud. And I want to wish her luck as she enters into Selden Middle School next year. I know you will do amazing things. And I'm going to miss definitely that smile, as you can see right now, every day in the hallway. We will miss you greatly. And on behalf of the Board of Education, Stagecoach, congratulations.
Congratulations, Stella. And now for our PTA, PTSA reports. We're going to have three reports this evening. So if I could please have Ms. Kim Nelson, PTA President at Stagecoach Elementary, join us at the podium.
Hello. I'm Kim Nelson. I am a second-year president at Stagecoach Elementary. I've been on the board for 4 years now. This year has been wonderful at Stagecoach. I think our board has gotten to a point where we know what our families like and what our community likes, so everybody has a role, so we're just copy and pasting every year, and it's been pretty successful. Most recently, we finished up with PARP, which is only a week long at Stagecoach. However, I think that we do a much different job than other schools. We don't focus on sending home reading logs and incentivizing it with just awards after school. We feel that children that read already read, so we like to reach the kids that don't really read. And we're very lucky at Stagecoach to have a staff and Mr. Rothberg who are very supportive in helping us accomplish that and making it equitable for all students. Because if a kid goes home and they read at home, and then they get awarded after school, there's really nothing there. And the entire board at Stagecoach were all working moms, so it's very hard for us to be there during the day to pull off things like this. Mr. Rothberg is very open to having anything that the PTA needs done in the school, and the staff follow suit. So the whole school gets decorated, it looks brilliant, it's to theme. This year our theme was space, blast into reading. So not only even though it is a PTA-funded event, it's really the teachers and the staff. We're very lucky that it's not reliant on us to create a curriculum for these kids for that week. We have the educators doing it, which is phenomenal. And not only that, but they put on shows for the kids during school. I think this year they did a Hollywood Squares, yes, which the kids don't remember. I remember that. And then, you know, of course, they do drop everything and read. One of the teacher's husbands came in, and he dressed up as Darth Vader, thank you, and read to the winning grade who handed in the most of their stuff. Most recently, and I'm going to make this very quick, but I just want to acknowledge something. Most recently, Niche, which is a platform that uses the education and community to review districts on Long Island, they put forth a Sweet 16, and it's an A-plus for 16 schools in Suffolk County, and Stagecoach was one of them, for their teachers, yes. So that's phenomenal, and that's important to the PTA because Mr. Rothberg is a wonderful leader. He really cares about the students, but he's also a teacher's principal, and that's not an easy accomplishment to do both. And it's important to the PTA because when the teachers are happy, the children are happy, it trickles down. And I feel that our staff at Stagecoach is so supportive in anything that the PTA needs. And our community is so involved because he makes us very visible to them because he's so supportive of us. And that kind of leadership cultivates community. And we're a very small school, so that's very important. And it also creates a sense of pride. So that's really important to the PTA. And it's been really an honor serving as president for the last 2 years. I can say that I don't know that I would last in any other school because it's a very difficult job. But having the support of the staff and Mr. Rothberg has made all the difference. And my oldest is going into middle school next year, but I still have 2 more years. So I won't be president because they don't allow it, but I will still continue on. And that's it. Thank you so much for allowing me to speak.
Thank you. And if I could now please have Ms. Megan Bidegain, PTA President of Dawnwood Middle School.
I apologize if I
don't worry about that. I still don't pronounce it right, so it's okay. My name is Megan Bidegain. I am the first year at principal. I'm looking at the principal over there. The president for Dawnwood. My son is in seventh grade. I just wanted to let everybody know a couple events that we did do this year so far and some upcoming events that we have. Earlier this year, we did our Dawnwood cards, which was a phenomenal success. We did great with that, and we always do each year. This year for the Halloween dance, the school approached us to sponsor to give every person that came ice cream. So we paid for all the ice cream trucks that were there for the 3 days. We helped Mr. Dowler with donation of $1,000 towards the new scoreboard that we want to put up in the school. For Valentine's Day, we gave every student and staff in the school the option to come to a hot chocolate bar where they got it for free. Every student enjoyed it. We got these really cool heart-shaped marshmallows, and you would think we gave them gold. So they enjoyed that. We had our book fair for the last 2 days. It was a great success. All the students came in. They came in during their lunch periods, and they're looking forward to it again next year. They asked if we can do it twice, so we are debating if we're going to do it in the fall for them. Upcoming, we have teacher appreciation. We're going to do a little bit different this year. We're going to do a theme of around the world. So each day, the staff will receive a different kind of small treat from a different country around the world, which there sounds like everybody's looking forward to it. We also have eighth grade coming up. We're preparing and helping the teachers with doing a little bit more for them this year for their eighth grade ceremony for moving up. And that's all I have, but thank you for having me tonight. And as always, thank you for all your support you give our students. Thank you.
Thank you. And lastly, if I could please have Ms. Michelle Young, PTA President of Selden Middle School, to the podium.
Hello. I'm letting you know I'm going to try to be quick. I'm running on caffeine right now, just from work. So, okay. My name's Michelle Young, and I am the PTA president at Selden Middle School. It is my first year in the middle school. I'm also the vice president over at Hawkins Path. So thank you for letting me be here to showcase all of the things that we've done so far. So September was our Selden Saver Card, and it was actually the first time we did it digitally because it was a risk. It was super nerve-wracking. But I'm happy to share that we broke the record for Selden Middle School, raising over $22,000, which was really, really exciting. So you take the risk, it pays off. All right, October, we had the sixth grade dance. The kids were so excited because, again, their first official dance, sixth grade. November, Arts and Ed, we brought back Rowan Murphy. So he is the wrestler, and he's also a motivational speaker. We've had him at the school before, and he's phenomenal, and the kids are really receptive. December, we had our holiday boutique. The kids love shopping for family. What I noticed in middle school is they shop more for friends than they do family. January, we had Cake Wars. First time at Selden Middle School, they brought that over. My board brought it over from actually the elementary school they used to do it at. We had the cakes donated from BJ's, and it was super successful. The kids came, they got to partner with friends and family, and they had a really, really good time. February was a little bit quiet. We had our Scholastic Book Fair. I will say you don't get as much as you do in the elementary school with that, but again, gave it to the kids. They loved it. March, we had, which was my first experience of Red and White Night. So much fun. If you haven't been there, super, super exciting. The white team won, but it was really great how the teachers got involved. Mr. Bennett plays the drums, if you guys did not know that, and he is amazing at it. They had their own band. It was super competitive and super fun. April, we had another Arts and Ed. We are partnering with the Cradle of Aviation for a drones event. May, we will have our seventh grade dance, and we will have From the Fires, which is an assembly around the Holocaust, and it does go tie into the current curriculum. June will be a little busier. We have our BMX event, which we've done at the elementary school, and it's such a huge success. We will host the eighth grade dance and all of the breakfast for all three grades. And let's see, and we received several awards from the New York State PTA this year. We got the Early Bird Award for having 50% of our membership in by September 30th. And I would like to say that we actually had the total amount in by September 30th, so super exciting. And we got the Super Teacher Staff Award, which I feel like is really important because it just shows that the staff is involved in the PTA. And the parents like to see that. So that was something that not a lot of schools got recognized for, but Selden Middle School did. So I couldn't have done it alone, so I thank my entire board. I thank the staff at the middle school. And we're looking forward to finishing off the year great. Thank you.
Thank you, and thank you to the three of you that spoke this evening on behalf of the Board of Education. We are truly grateful and appreciative of all that the volunteers for the PTA and PTA essays do, so we thank you for that. There will now be a brief intermission, sorry. we would like to please Stella, if you'd like to join us to take a picture, and then we'll come back. Thank you.
There we go. There we are. Yes, photos in the lobby, please, with Stella.
wait till you sit. Is this? Oh, it is on. Thank you so much for giving us a moment to take a photo with our student who is honored here this evening. We are now going to present to you the 24-25 proposed budget for the school year 24-25. We love that. We keep that in every year. And just to note that he was in pre-K in the school year 14-15. He is now an eighth grader at Selden Middle School, so I think that's kind of neat. I'm now going to ask you all to stand and then remain standing. We have the Newfield High School students reciting the pledge where they were on a music trip in Boston, where they visited the JFK Presidential Library and Museum. And then we have alum from Center Reach High School, Frankie Pabone, who will be performing this, he performed the Star Spangled Banner at the Ducks Ballpark.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, under God, to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Here we have Newfield High School Tri-M officers once again at the JFK Presidential Library and Museum to recite the mission statement for us.
The mission of the Middle Country, Central School District is to empower and inspire all students
to apply the knowledge,
skills, and attitudes necessary
to be creative problem solvers,
to achieve personal success,
and to contribute responsibly
in a diverse and dynamic world.
Our budget planning objective to support a comprehensive pre-K through grade 12 program that provides students with opportunities, resources, and support so that they are successfully involved in schooling and extracurricular activities, and to do so by staying within the allowable tax levy cap. Some of our 24-25 budget challenges: fiscal distress designation, second year in a row of double-digit healthcare cost increases, active 10%, and retirees range from 18 to 25%. That was a $5 million impact here at Middle Country. Also, our growing high needs population, an addition of 2 to 3 praise classes, that's between $750,000 and $1.1 million. our fiscal stress designation as you for a 22-23 school year. As you can see, 25 to 44.9% is susceptible. We had 25 points. Dr. Rella made a presentation on the successable to fiscal stress designation that we received. You can see the entire presentation along with any information that we are in this presentation here. You can go onto our website. You can click through everything at your leisure. You can see all the slides as well as past budget presentations or any other presentations. Our budget presentation started in September, so all of those are on the website that you can look for. The use of our reserves and fund balance history, as you can see, in the last 6 years, the district has utilized the reserves to maintain our instructional programs. The district's reserve balance has decreased 50% over the last 6 years. There is 1 year in 22 that I want to note to you that shows a slight increase, and that was because we received our federal grants to help offset the cost of the COVID impact. Another thing that we had mentioned earlier on in the slides of the impact of the health insurance, our health insurance carry is NYSHIP. And as you can see here, the rate changes through the last 10 years. And what's also important to note is the last 2 years represent a 29% increase in the rate. That is greater than the 8 years combined. Some cost reduction savings. And once again, like I said, you can read through all of these. You can go onto the website if you really want to see all of the bullets that we have here. We took careful consideration to not, for things that we could do in cost reductions that are the least impactful to students. And I just want to note too, I'm sorry, if you could just go back. One reduction, as I'm sure you're all aware of, we went from 108 electives to 79. A few of those electives that were paused for this year had no or very small student enrollments. In addition to the 79 electives available to our high school students, our BOCES programs, such as auto mechanics, culinary arts, and welding, as well as our in-district cosmetology program was kept intact. Here is the 24-25 proposed expenditures, which as you can see is broken into three parts. Capital at 14%, administrative at 7%, and then our largest at 77% is programs. This here is just another way to look at it. There's a variance of 8.9 million or 3.13% increase. Our 24-25 proposed revenue, the total revenue proposed is $294 million. Again, it's that 8.9 million dollars. The budget expenditures need to be supported by revenues. The two primary sources of revenues are property tax and state aid. Middle Country is a state aid dependent district, which means any underfunding in state aid requires either program reductions or an increase in taxes, or overuse of reserves if they are still available. And just to note, to put that into context, every 1.5 million in state aid reduction is 1% on the tax levy. So this year, in the governor's proposal, we were slated to receive about 1.5 million less in state aid than current law requires. This is our tax levy increase over the last 10 years, and as you can see, our average has been 1.94%. This is also a good time to just a reminder that 2% isn't truly 2%. Each district, and even year to year, as you can see here by our chart, it's always a different number. It's a formula that's given. We actually had 1 year that it was negative. And Middle Country is always very respectful of that and mindful of that number, and we stay within that allowable tax levy cap. The budget this year stays within our allowable tax levy cap of 2.54%. That translates to an average annual increase of $168 or $14 a month. Now, I just want to also note that that is for the averaged assessed property of $2,500. That is the latest number we received from the town of Brookhaven. The next slide here is our tax calculator. So if you go onto the website and you want to know exactly what it means for your household, you would get your assessed value of your tax bill and punch it into the calculator on the website, and it'll give you exactly what the increase to your household will be. Our 24-25 proposed budget, our current budget is $285 million. Our proposed budget is $294 million. Expenditure increase of 3.13%. Tax levy cap, like I said, 2.54%. We are coming in at 2.54%. That again, the annual increase to homeowners assessed at that average of $2,500 is $168. The slide you never want to talk about, but we have to because it's it could be a reality. A contingent budget would create a 3.9% gap. And once again, the things that would be impacted would be programs and staff, that's pre-K, additional electives, class size, K through 12, field trips, sports and clubs, late buses, charges for building and field use, equipment and supply purchases. Those are the things that we would have to, that we wouldn't have a choice. We would have to create that or fill that gap of the $3.9 million, and it needs to be on the big ticket items. It wouldn't be paper clips and copy paper. So unfortunately, if it does fail, that's what we're looking at. Here in Middle Country, we are extremely proud of everything that this district offers to our students. We have created bulletin boards. As you can see, our latest one there is our story, because we are proud of our story. Some of them have been sent home to your houses, not all of them, but if you go on to the website, you can click on a link that will take you to all of our bulletin boards. This way you can look through at your leisure and just see we've highlighted different departments. Like I said, our story, we have a lot of student achievement, staff achievement, so if you'd like to go on and take a look at those. Throughout the years, this is just what our operating budget has accomplished. Like I said, these are some of our highlights. I know one in particular, this graduating class, the year of 24, will be the first to graduate with the capstone requirements. That's something that has been a baby to a few of the board members and cabinet members up there. First started in 2014, so this is it's pretty impressive that this is the first class. I think it's exciting for all of us. And once again, please, if you would like to go onto the website so you can read each bullet, please do that. All this information will be up there. Here now, I love these slides because I think it just really shows and highlights how competitive our students are and everything that our budget does accomplish and give to our students here in Middle Country. The class of 23, an impressive $7.8 million in scholarships. Now that includes academic and sports, and I think it just shows once again that our students are competitive in both of those fields. I just want to also note that this scholarship money is not just from the colleges they're going to be attending. It's our PTAs, it's our local businesses, so we want to thank those who do that because they also help our students, and every little bit counts when you're going away to college. From the year 2018 to 23, the average cost of scholarships was $3.5 million, which again is impressive. And we really need to congratulate the students because they are truly earning those scholarships. Here is just another slide that just shows you once again how competitive our students are. Because in addition to military, which we thank the students for their service who go right into the military after graduating, and also students who go on to work into the trades, this is a list of 265 different colleges that our students are attending. This I love. Elementary students learn about civic engagement through voting. This will be our second year. We started I guess an initiative, you could say, where the elementary school students in school are voting for, that's the favorite lunch they vote for in school. They all cast their vote on the day of this school board election. Then the winner of that is then put on the lunch calendar so they can see this was the results of their vote that they had. And some of these kids, I think, are getting smart and they can kind of campaign for what their favorite lunch is to get others to join them and vote in on that. We then students who accompany the adults in their life who are coming to vote after school to the school to the election, they also will be given an opportunity to cast another vote for a different question. This is about recess, and this year we're really excited because Ms. Larkin was able to get one of the actual voting tables or booths for the students. We were able to lower it to their height so that everybody can reach. They'll then sign in like their parents do or sign their name, and then they cast their ballot. We are also doing here, as you can see this year, the I voted sticker. We did that last year as well. Every student who votes in school and votes after school, and any adult as well, I will say we saw a lot of adults walking out, you get the I voted sticker. This year, it was designed by, I'm sorry, Center Reach High School student Kyra Wynn. She, this also was voted on from the students at our first Humanity Expo. We had four stickers that were created. Every student went up to the table and they chose which sticker they thought. They cast their ballot and this was the winner. So students will receive that sticker when they vote on election day. And then just a reminder, Tuesday, May 21st, we ask you to please come out and vote in the rear gyms at Center Reach High School, Newfield High School. The polls are open from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. You are split up, the high schools are split up by your zip code. So if for some reason you're unsure of your zip code, which high school you should be voting at, please don't hesitate to call Ms. Larkin and you give her your zip code and she will tell you which high school you are to go to vote. Any questions? All right, thank you. Okay, board commentary, Mr. Halleck.
Pass.
Mr. DiBenedetto.
I just quickly want to thank Ms. McNichols, fourth grade class, Hawkins Road, for inviting me in to read the other day, well, actually a couple weeks ago. It's just nice to have the opportunity to read to fourth graders, other than my son, and something I don't get a chance to do at the high school level, so it was a nice experience to get back into elementary classroom. So thank you for inviting me.
Thank you. Ms. Mann Rodriguez? Ms. Haggerty? Ms. Barisi?
It's on? This past week we went to the North Coleman Founders Day. I'm going to tell you, those kids were absolutely adorable. They did such a great job. And then we went to International Night at Center Reach High School, Newfield High School. And I'm telling you, the amount of different kinds of foods and the kids representing different countries was really something to be seen. I was really proud to see all the kids there and the dancing and the shows and how they just celebrated the international that we have within our district. Also today I went to a chamber meeting and I just want to share that Diane Cargiulo, the president of the Center Reach Civic, really went to see Newsy, and she said it rivaled any Broadway show that she had seen. She couldn't believe how great it was. So again, there are kids highlighting and doing the best that we can ever expect from anybody. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Walsh? Ms. Feldman? Mr. Feeney? I just wanted to say, too, while we were at Founders Day, this was nice. I won't get into the specifics of it because we must follow our own policies, too. But I did have a parent who approached me and Ms. Feldman, and she said, "You're on the board?" And I said, "Yes." She said, "Okay, I need to let you know that the teachers here are wonderful." She said, "I'm sure that the teachers throughout the whole district are wonderful, but the teachers here really went above and beyond for my children and for my son in particular." And she let us know, an IEP, right? But she wanted us to know how above and beyond they went, and that her son is now, she said, he graduated with honors. He is away from her in Southern Florida University, living his life and having the college experience. And she just could not stop raving and gushing. And she said, you need to hear the good things and the positive as well. And she said, "I just wanted to let you know." And I told her that I would share what I could. And she was appreciative of that. And she was very thankful for the teachers we have here. So it was very nice to hear. We have minutes from our regular meeting from April 3rd. If there are no comments or edits, we'll accept them as they are. Thank you. I need a motion to accept the consent agenda. Instruction, no action. Pupil personnel services. Personnel instructional. Finance. All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries.
Section 24-04-SR-3, stipulation of settlement, section 75.
All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries.
24-04-SR-4, Eastern Suffolk BOCES administrative budget for the 2024-2025 school year.
All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries.
24-04-SR-5, Eastern Suffolk BOCES annual election, and the candidates are Arlene Barisi, Angelo Casarino, Kellyanne Jennings, James F. McKenna, Brian O'Mealy, and Robert P. Sweeney.
All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries.
24-04-SR-6, scope summer enrichment program contract for 2024.
All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries.
24-04-SR-7, scope before and after school and summer child care program contract for the 2024-25 school year.
All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries.
24-04-SR-8, settlement agreement and release CVA.
All those in favor? Opposed? Thank you. Motion carries, I'm sorry.
24-04-SR-9, property tax report card for the 2024-25 school year, and a roll call is required.
I will call your name in alphabetical order, with the vice president and president being last. Please respond by saying yes, no, or abstain after your name is called. Ms. Barisi. Ms. DiBenedetto.
Yes.
Ms. Feldman.
Yes.
Ms. Haggerty. Mr. Halleck?
Yes.
Ms. Mann Rodriguez?
Yes.
Ms. Walsh?
Yes.
Mr. Feeney?
Yes.
Ms. Chirac?
Yes.
At this time, would anybody like to change their vote? Being no trustee has changed his or her vote, the motion is unanimously carried 9-0. Thank you.
Thank you. 24-04-SR-10, 2024-2025 school year budget adoption and a roll call vote is required.
I'm sorry, who was the first motion?
Denise.
Thank you. And it was Bob Feeney?
Yes.
Roll call vote. I think we all know what we need to do. Ms. Parisi, yes, no, or abstain? Mr. DiBenedetto?
Yes.
Ms. Feldman? Ms. Haggerty?
Yes.
Mr. Halleck?
Yes.
Ms. Mann Rodriguez?
Yes.
Ms. Walsh?
Yes.
Mr. Feeney?
Yes.
And Ms. Sharrock?
Yes.
Would anyone like to change their vote? Again, being no trustee has changed his or her vote, the motion is being carried unanimously 9-0. Thank you.
Thank you. Policy 24-04-PO-2, first reading of policy 6710, purchasing authority.
I need a first motion for the first reading, please. First.
So first.
All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Do you need all in favor, right?
Yes, please. Yes.
All in favor? Opposed? Motion carries.
Super. Thank you.
Thank you.
Correspondence, before I say my usual, I am just going to thank you all in advance. I know that this is going to become our busy time where we are going to be having to be out at meetings every night, several meetings possibly a night. So I thank you all for signing up for any event that we're invited to so that we represent and we show the students and staff we support them. So I thank you for that. If you could just be responding to your emails, if anything changes, let myself or Stephanie know so that we can let the building or the event we're going to know and plan accordingly. Unfinished business, new business, committee reports, liaison to district community committee reports. Oh, I'm so sorry, Ms. Feldman. It's very hard to see.
Home, so I'm just going to wing this, even though I was at the committee today. The school business partnership, we had a meeting today, and we discussed the career exploration, where this year we have over 20 students have signed up, which is good. Could be better, but it's a lot better than it's been. But I'm putting this call out to all of you. We still need either bakers, like a bakery, or people who bake, if they want to let the kids shadow them. Anesthesiologist, an architect, and a psychologist. They're gonna present to us on May 20th and May 22nd. So I'm just asking if we could have the Karen Lesler room on those days from like, I think it's 3 to 5. But if you can let us know if we could have that day, those days. And then June 12th, we'd like to know if we can present the CCE students to the Board of Ed. I think it's our only board meeting in June. We have quite a few of our classes that are gonna be at the Chamber Music Festival. Cosmo, robotics, childcare, there were more, but like I said, those notes are home. We also had an entrepreneur come in to the meeting today. It was very interesting. She's working with other school districts, and they do holistic teaching, and she does power garden farms, where they could build the farms in the classroom, say in September, and the kids can eat this stuff all year long, or if say it's a cooking class, they could use it to cook. One of our surrounding districts has 75 of these farms stands in their classrooms. That's what she said, right?
Yeah, they're just like a big pole that goes up. I saw it when I was in Epcot. The nice thing about it is it's completely funded by Arts and Ed. So the kids can plant it. You don't need any kind of dirt. Well, it's done by water and fertilizer. And, you know, Mark was there and he heard it too. It sounded very interesting. And we can also get food from it, which is really nice. And so we told him to call you, Rachel.
Yes, because science classes would be great for them.
What were they called again? Sorry.
It's, I wrote down that it's the Power Garden Farms. Now, it's $1,271 for each stand. But if we do get the money back, because it's totally 100% aidable from BOCES.
Do we have or do we have something similar in some of the classes? I felt like when we were walking through the middle schools, we saw...
We do have them growing in different schools, but this is something that they would grow all year round, and it's in the classroom.
Yeah, I felt
it's like the size of a person.
Yeah, I felt like in the middle school we saw that maybe in one or two classrooms. I don't know, maybe it was a little different, but I remember they had some sort of garden right in there when we walked through. But no, yes, we wrote it down. So thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody else? Committee reports or liaison reports? Follow-up board discussion. Public input. We had no public input from our last meeting, so nothing to report out.
No public input this evening.
Thank you. I need a motion to adjourn. All those in favor?